I'm here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, where you guys sent in many, many questions for Robert.
Your thoughts on Mikey Garcia knocking out a former Sinaloa cartel member who died 2 months after the fight?
How do you know he was a cartel member?
I have no idea what this quiz is coming from.
I don't know, yeah.
All right, Thomas Hugson, would you consider Brandon versus Broner at lightweight or Danny Garcia at light welterweight?
Brandon's not a lightweight anymore. Brandon's not a lightweight, so why would you consider even fighting at lightweight?
Light welterweight versus Danny Garcia.
And much worse, but Brandon's gonna be fine. Well, he's gonna be fine, so whatever they bring to us.
Jesse Max, what is an ideal amount of weight to cut for an in-shape boxer without cutting an unhealthy amount of weight? Like a good amount of weight.
Good in good shape. Water weight, maybe 3-4 pounds, 5 max. That's probably healthy, yeah. Water weight, but not when you're already dying and you still gotta lose 5 pounds, then that's gonna kill you.
Eddie De La Huerta, now that Ortiz is now with Danny, would you take Ortiz versus Maidana too?
Would I take Ortiz
versus the fight? Ortiz versus Maidana too. Now
oh, fuck, yeah, in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. I would love it.
All right, the boxing seat, have you ever taught or fought a Canadian fighter?
I don't think so, no.
Eddie, are you Canadian?
What?
No, it is Puerto Rican.
Puerto Rican. Why'd you ask me that?
Because someone asked Robert if he ever trained a Canadian fighter.
I'll say yeah if you can shout me out. Detroit, yeah. Detroit, yeah. Detroit, yeah. Detroit, you can be in Detroit and look across and see Canada. My dad's from Detroit, so. Well, Pennsylvania, but Pennsylvania.
Ellie, this guy's asking if you're going to stay for the whole 3 weeks.
Yeah, I am, but I'll answer that afterwards.
All right, cool. About how many rounds should a pro boxer should spar for a 4-round fight? Adrian Zamora.
Want me to answer that?
Yeah.
You asked the same question?
Three. I say 3 hard rounds and you rest for the last one and then get up and shoot 4 more.
But don't hit the back before you spar,
yeah,
right?
Don't hit the back. Two rounds is enough.
2 rounds, you're going to be too fucking tired. Fucking pussy.
So wait, ask the question. How many rounds
should a fighter spar if he's fighting 4-round fights?
When you're fighting 4-round fights, we got a lot of 4-rounders. We don't count the rounds. They spar 2-3 times a week, 4-6 rounds at a time. And then they fight, they take a week or two off, and then they come back to the gym and keep doing, when you do like a championship fight, then you start 2 months before, you keep a schedule of how many rounds he's gonna spar, because it's a championship fight. But 4-round fighters, they could fight anytime. They could call us tonight about fighting this weekend, So 4-round fighters just have to be in the gym all the time, sparring 2-3 times a week.
That's it.
That was it. So what do you say about all the questions you got, Robert? A lot of questions, huh?
That's good. I like it.
Any message to your fans out there?
Huh?
Any message to your fans?
Gotta go back to work.
There you have it. So there you have it from the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. For YouTubeReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback.